Welcome back to the WDSU News Hot Seat. I'm Norman Robinson. Tonight we're examining New Orleans Mayor Mitch Landrieu's first year in office. The question is, are we any better off a year later? The mayor says we are, his supporters says we are, but admits that violent crime continues to gnaw at the social fabric of the city and her attempts to progress. Here's WDSU reporter Gina Swanson with some highlights.
Mr. Mayor, we're sorry to inform you that earlier this evening, police officers responded to gunshots. When they arrived on the scene, they found a young African-American male face down in blood, gunshots in the back of his head. He was announced dead on arrival. There are no witnesses.
It's a voicemail the mayor says he's both familiar with and fed up with. Another murder on the streets. The dark side of a city, Landrieu says, has infinite possibilities. Addressing the culture of violence has become issue number one for the mayor in his second year in office.
It is the single most important issue facing our city. A whole generation of young people is being lost to the streets.
The mayor says combating the crime problem will take effort from every part of the community. He announced the creation of a crime commissioner and a strategic command that would serve as a war room to combat murder, as well as a citywide summit on violence. All of this as the city is already on pace for more killings this year than last.
Last year, New Orleans had 175 murders. In the first 4 months of this year, there have been another 70.
Beyond the personal, analysts say the crime problem is political. Dr. Silas Lee believes for the Landrieu administration to be considered a success, it has to get violence under control.
Public safety becomes the bellwether evaluator, whereby citizens judge the success or the failure sometimes for elected officials.
On your side, Gina Swanson, WDSU News.
Again, I'm joined by Mayor Mitch Landrieu, and again, thank you, Mr. Mayor, for being here on the hot seat with us. On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the highest, what number would you assign your administration's accomplishments so far?
7.
7?
Mm-hmm.
That's,
yeah,
that's
I think
pretty
we,
good.
It is good. I think we had a good year. I think the people of the city had a good year. If you just think about the past couple of months, we had a Mardi Gras with the largest ever that went off without a hitch. We had a great French Quarter Festival. Jazz Festival is in the middle of their biggest event. I think the happiness of the people of the city of New Orleans and the confidence is up, and I think that's good. We had a lot to do when we first got here. We found an $80 million budget hole, which was about 25% of our budget annualized. We had a BP oil spill that we were dealing with. We had to restructure all of government. We did the hard work very early on. You know, people said, look, crime, jobs, schools, let's get on that. And so you've seen a lot of stuff that we've done. We've gotten blight moving in the right direction. We reorganized the New Orleans Recreation Department. We've created a new economic development engine that's moving in the right direction. And I feel good about our ability to kind of stop the bleeding, stabilize the patient, you know, and to start moving forward. But again, as I said in my inaugural speech, as I said in the Eyes Wide Open speech, as I said the other day, we are really rebuilding a city from ground up, and we have to stay focused on the future, not thinking about what we were, but thinking about what we want to become. A lot of hard work. I've got a good group of folks that work with me. They work hard every day. It wouldn't be successful if the community wasn't involved. We've had great community involvement. Thousands of volunteers have helped us do all of our work, had great buy-in by the faith-based community and the not-for-profit sector. So I feel really good about that. Now, nobody promised to fix all the problems in a year. They're not fixable in a year. They may not be fixable in a decade. Right? The idea is to lay a strong foundation so that those of us that come after us have a much better place to start from than what we found.
What would you point to as your biggest or greatest accomplishment so far?
Well, I think really just stabilizing the city and restoring hope to its people.
Stopping
the bleeding. Now, there are a whole bunch of examples of things that we did to get that to that place. But if you think about it, just in the arc of history, I mean, we're occupying a very small moment in time, but stabilizing the city, stopping the bleeding and just moving in the right direction is a major accomplishment. I think we got that done together as a city, and I feel really good about that.
What about the crime problem?
Well, here's the biggest, here really is long-term the biggest challenge for the city. You have two separate things going on. They're both opposite and they're both true. Crime, for the most part, in every major category in New Orleans is not unlike any other city in America. It's been trending down over a period of time, except for one. And this is something that the Department of Justice report highlighted, and that is murders, which is in our city, in my opinion, the most important issue. Now, this is not something that's just going to be solved by a better police department, although we're making a better police department. You got to get on the front of it. So you got to work with the New Orleans Recreation Department. We've doubled their budget. We have 31 summer camps up and operating. It's also going to be done by giving kids jobs. We have 3,000 kids that are going to get jobs this summer. But that ain't going to fix it by itself either. We need a community effort, which is what I announced the other day during the State of the City address. James Carter is going to come on as our public crime commissioner. He's going to work with the police chief. We're going to redouble our efforts. We got to get the whole community involved, because at the end of the day, this is about, and this is what I've talked about, a tragic event, young African-American men killing young African-American men. They know each other. It's usually over an argument that they had that people forget the day later, and they're solving the problems by shooting themselves, you know, in the head with guns. That is a huge problem,
That sounds esoteric. So how do you get to that?
Let me say this. If anybody knew the answer to that question, we would have it solved right now. But the first question is, why is New Orleans different than the rest of the country? Because we are different. What if you treat crime like a public health issue, how would that look differently from just treating it as a law and order issue? We're going to try to do both. We're going to ask the federal government, the state government, the local government, and the community to come together to get their arms wrapped around this. You need psych services, you need substance abuse services, you need preventative measures, you need a good recreation department, you need jobs, you need all of it, right? And so as a community, I'm just asking the people this year, let's focus on that as well as, you know, holding us accountable for continuing to run the government really well.
Specifically, what is James Carter, the former city council member, going to do as police commissioner that you couldn't do with the police chief?
Well, he's not the police commissioner. He's the person who's going to help coordinate the criminal justice system. There already is a position that has been around for the last 16 years that actually does that. But what he is going to help me do is coordinate the activities between the DA, the judges, municipal, right, and traffic court, work with the police chief, work with and be my point person for working with all those different agencies, pull them together, accumulate their resources, focus their attention, right, and work with the police chief and me and the faith-based community to come up with a comprehensive plan to deal with all areas of crime and especially murder.
Now, here's what some critics have opined. Here he goes again, he being Mayor Landrieu, adding another bureaucratic layer to government with a salary and a staff the taxpayers must support. What do you say to that?
Well, first of all, we didn't add another layer of anything. The layer's already there. It was a job that's been open for the past 11 months, and we finally found the right person and we filled it.
All right. Former Mayor Ray Nagin recently took a shot at you over the fact that Armstrong Park has been closed for a year and you haven't done anything about the repairs to reopen it. What do you say to the former mayor?
Well, the first thing is, I think we ought not be looking back rather than forward. But in an effort to set the record straight, we had to kick the people off of that project. I mean, there were felons who were given the contract. They destroyed the park. And we said we're going to do something different. What happened was they sued us, and the surety sued us, and they've been having us in court. I didn't want to have to pay them to do work that they didn't do and then ask the taxpayers to pay it again. So we've now got that business straight. The park's going to be open at the end of the year. That's just another example of, you know, stuff that's in the past. I just assume not getting a tit-for-tat with the ex-mayor. I hope he's doing well. But Armstrong Park's going to be open, and it's going to be a great symbol for the city again.
And what date do you expect it to be?
Hopefully it's going to be. It'll be open before the end of the year.
You say hopefully?
It's going to be open before the end of the year. But don't ever forget how we got here. All right.
Oh, I'm not forgetting that
good,
part. I'm
good.
Just asking,
exactly.
You know, when you say it's going to be open, I'm just asking
if that's
your thing.
It'll be open before the end of
this year. All right. Because, you know, you can hope for something, and then there's a certainty
hope
of something.
Hope is cheap, right? Oh, hope,
yeah, absolutely.
It'll be open.
You said also on 60 Minutes that you're not defensive about the city of New Orleans. You get pissed about people who
that's a
question.
What happened was, is, and this happens with national correspondents, and people of New Orleans know this and they feel this in their heart and their soul, and it troubles them, that people from across this country always look down on us, and they say New Orleans is somehow this strange place that just doesn't fit in the universe, and that people down there, there's something wrong with them. And I have, this is not the first time that I've done this. I've testified before Congress in a very forceful way right after Katrina, when a lawmaker from New Jersey and then one from Illinois and then one from Connecticut accused the people of New Orleans of being more corrupt. And I had to remind them that of all of the problems that they have in their particular states, and that what they ought to be doing is trying to help us and not find an excuse not to help us. And so I will defend aggressively the good nature and the wonderful people of the city of New Orleans anytime somebody takes what I consider to be an unfair shot. And so I used the word pissed, and people thought that was cute. But the essential emotion is, listen, get your foot off our throats. You know, we're trying to do something that no other people in America have ever been asked to do, and we're doing it really, really well. And the people down here are really resilient. Give us a chance and try to help us out. You will notice, given the tragedy this week in Tuscaloosa and other places, that no national correspondents asked the question of, why should we rebuild Tuscaloosa? But for some reason, they asked that about New Orleans. I want people to quit doing that. It's a glorious place. We love it. We're here. It's our home. We're going to build it back, whether people help us or not, and we're going to make it happen.
All right. Thank you for being here. Good. And making this happen.
Thank you, Norman.
All right. Good luck. That's all the time we have. Thanks to my guest, New Orleans Mayor Mitch Landrieu, and thanks to you for watching. Now let's head back over to the news.